There are several fields in mathematics, in particular combinatorics, where you often have to multiply the first n positive integers together. For example, 1 times 2 times 3 times 4, or 1 times 2 times 3 times 4 times 5 times 6 times 7, and so forth. It comes up often enough that we have a special name and a special notation for it. It's called a factorial. And the factorial is defined this way. The factorial of a non-negative integer is all of the positive integers less than or equal to it multiplied together. And we write a factorial using an exclamation point. For example, 5 factorial would be written 5 followed by an exclamation point and is equal to 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 or 120. Now, there are a couple of details that you should take special note of here. First is this a non-negative integer part. All that means is that we don't do the factorials of negative numbers. We don't do the factorials of numbers that have fraction or decimal parts like 1/2 or 0.3. It's only something that we do for non-negative integers. You should also pay special attention to this last part. 0 factorial is defined to be equal to 1. That may seem a little counterintuitive at first. You know, I know we usually think of anything multiplied by 0 as being 0, but in this case, that's really kind of a practical part of the definition. There are going to be times when we're talking about any number of things, in particular sequences and series, when having 0 factorial just defined as being equal to 1 is going to make writing things out, is going to make the notation for some things a whole lot simpler to work with. So using our definition, the numbers that I started out with as examples here would be written 4 factorial, 7 factorial, and 10 factorial, respectively. Now, this table shows the numeric values for the first 9 factorials. 0 factorial up to 8 factorial. So you can see, you know, 5 factorial is equal to 120, 8 factorial is equal to 40,320. And the one thing you should really notice from these values is that factorials increase really, really fast. Even for as small a value as 8, the factorial is already up over 40,000. This can make calculating factorials pretty challenging, even with a calculator. Fortunately for us, most of the situations that we will encounter in our lectures here are going to involve fractions where the numerator and denominator are both a factorial. And in those situations, we can take advantage of reducing the fraction first to make the calculations a little easier to work with.